May I request everyone to come and take your seats, please.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Merry Christmas. We will come to the Christmas celebration jointly organized by the United Evangelical Lutheran Churches in India and
Gurukul Lutheran Theological College and Research Institute.
It will be a great joy if all our students' friends were here on the campus.
Friends, we are all here in the Ziegenberg Auditorium.
And for those of you who have not been on the campus yet and are viewing on the virtual platform, I want to say that our campus is beautifully decorated and even this hall is incredible. And our friends have worked very hard to make this place so beautiful.
We are here this evening to make this celebration most magnificent one. So from the time we started saying good evening, all are tensed and very serious, right? So you can relax, please, and you can respond. And we are here to rejoice and celebrate the good news of what the Lord has done, the biggest celebration of this year, 2021. And we are all aware that 2020 Christmas was pale in a sense. The campus was empty, and we have more people today in our campus, and it's a joyous occasion. It's a time to thank God. So this is going to be the celebration of 2021 Christmas program. I am Jeba Singh, and with me is
Gloria Titupoy, and we will take you through this program this evening.
So we have a song, long time ago in Bethlehem. Right? So we always sing, and that good news that we are here to bring. So born with neither fame or any riches, born in a manger, yet different people from shepherds to great, they came and visited. A great peace was felt by everyone by the birth of this Savior of the world. It has been a tradition as during this time we come together to share the love of God.
Christmas is all about counting our blessings and sharing it with our family and friends. Today we are very happy to have gathered so that we can take the love of God to another level this year. We are thankful to God for allowing us to be here today to share the beauty in creation that is hardly taken in during this present day.
So I will ever stand in awe of grace and love that never ends. Christmas Eve lends us an opportunity to extend the love of Christ more than the daily experience. Christ resides in Christmas in more than one way. By knowing how Christ intended to draw hearts to freedom through salvation, we can be better equipped to offer an authentic experience today through and by resuscitating the creation.
At Christmas, we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. Let us keep in mind the truth of today's celebration, for it is not the Christmas wrappings nor the gifts that lie within, but our gift of love to one another in every way. Let us share the love with one another as we celebrate Christmas.
On this auspicious day, let us focus on joyfully receiving the gift of God's love and sharing it with one another.
With great pleasure in our hearts and smiles on our faces, we take pride in welcoming Reverend Dr. Wilson, the Associate Professor in the Department of Religion and the faculty in charge of spiritual activities of our college, to address us with a welcome note.
all in the matchless name of Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Friends, it is my great pleasure to welcome all of you to the Christmas celebration 2021 with the theme Resuscitate the Creation, organized by United Evangelical Lutheran Churches in India and Gurukul Lutheran Theological College and Research Institute. A very special word of welcome to UELCI Executive Secretary and our speaker for today, Reverend Joshua Peter Annan, and Gurukul College Principal, Reverend Dr. Songram Basumatari, UELCI staff and families, Gurukul College faculty, staff and students, and all the Gurukul family members, as we celebrate the Emmanuel, God with us, in a context where our lives are affected by the loss of lives, economy, health, and jobs. As we are at the end of 2021, our emotions are very high. There is an excitement, joy. There is an excitement and joy as we celebrate the birth of our Savior. And at the same time, there are families that we recognize who have lost their dear ones. So there is a mixed feeling with which we come this evening. And I believe it was the same with the first family that was celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. They were anxious, they were worried, as Mary and Joseph had to travel a distance to save the baby Jesus. They were anticipating the coming of the Savior of the world. And that night, as they tidied the place, and maybe they set just a bit more hay and stray around the baby, they were decorating the moment. They were celebrating the Savior. And that very night, another parent was at work too. God at that moment was heralding His love. God was painting Calvary beyond the cradle because God wanted you, me, and the whole creation to be a part of God's family. My dear friends, as we celebrate this Christmas, let us make Jesus as the center of this event. As we celebrate Christmas this season, let Jesus, creation, family, community, love, and hope be part of our celebration. As our dear friends began with saying that it is the love that we celebrate this evening, I believe in the context in which we are in now, we also need to celebrate the hope. There are people who are looking forward for the hope, the great expectation of the things to change in their lives. And this evening, as we celebrate Christmas, let us spread this message of love, hope, and peace to the people and the families and the community whose lives are shattered. As we celebrate this evening, I believe it is not the celebration that started now, but even when, as a family and community, we were preparing for this event this evening, I could come here, there were our students and friends who were decorating this whole beautiful auditorium. There were people who were helping in cooking. There were friends who were running around making other arrangements. I think that is the celebration of Christmas. It doesn't begin with a program like this, but celebration begins when, as a community, as families, we come together and do and share our joy and happiness with one another. So this day is a great day of joy and happiness that we are sharing with one another. This evening, as we come together, friends, let us continue the celebration of family and community where we find comfort, peace, and joy. May God bless us all as we go ahead with this program.
Thank you, dear sir, for giving the welcome note.
It is said that Christmas magic is silent. You don't hear it, but you feel it. We have a variety of Christmas carols for all of us to fill the ambience with true festive color. So get ready to witness a grand celebration. May this year Christmas celebration be more fulfilling, promising and joyous than all the years and spread happiness all around. And this could happen only through prayer.
So prayer is an action, a longing of our souls. It is a process of talking with God in order to achieve a purpose. So let us begin this program by seeking the blessing of our Almighty God. Now I call upon Reverend Dr. Peter Singh, the professor and the head of the Department of Communication, to come and grace this occasion with the word of prayer.
Let us pray. Loving God, we acknowledge the word of God had come alive. Love came, held safely within a gentle womb. All the truth, majesty, and creativity of a living God, making a quiet entrance in a dark and uninviting shack. Just one star brought contradictions together. Led by angelic voices and open hearts, a young mother, a faith-filled father, men of foolishness who searched Jesus in a wrong place, men of wise shepherds who rightly identified the place, they came to bow before a new life. God, as we gather this evening with diversities, may the Bethlehem star lead us to bow down before you. We celebrate your coming in the midst of loud lamentations and weeping. Numerous Rachels are still crying over the loss of their dear ones. Hunger and violence against innocent children, especially the girl children. Often our Christmas celebrations are Christless. Enable us, O God, to reach out to the Jesuses who long of love and life. Enable us, O God, to move beyond the cradle to the cross, to experience you in the hard realities of life. May this Christmas celebration now inspire us, disturb us, and motivate us. We pray this in the name of Jesus, the babe of Bethlehem. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Dr. Peter Singh, for making us be active in the presence of God Almighty by and throughout this program. Let this prayer be rooted in each and every one heart by the love, joy, and peace that are found in the Christmas. Christmas is a season of carols sung in beautiful harmony by one another. In filling a program with the joy of Christmas, let us praise God by singing a hymn, O Come, All Ye Faithful, Shall We All Rise Up.
Thank you. have faith. Oh come into Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation. Sing all his citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Hail, Lord, we greet thee, born this happy morning. Praises to thee be all glory given. Son of the Father, now in flesh appearing. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
You may all be seated, please. For the special Christmas greetings, may we call upon stage the principal of Gurukul Lutheran Theological College, Reverend Dr. Sangram Basumathari. And as he comes on the stage, I would call Sister Inokali to come and honor before he speak to us. Let's all put our hands together and honor our dear principal. The clap is not enough, I think. All right, thank you.
On that night, when Jesus was born, Father Joseph, Mother Mary, baby Jesus had no light. There was no star. But the light was shining in the jungle somewhere. Star was rising somewhere in the east. And that light in the jungle, star in the east, brought the world into the darkness where the light was, or the light of the world was resting. I am indeed overwhelmed to see the Gurukul auditorium this evening. I am rather confused whether 17th December is Christmas or 25th December is Christmas. Then I'm just eagerly thinking how 25th December will be here. So thankful to all the hard-working student body and the faculty in charge who have decorated this auditorium so beautifully. And then I can say in my experience here, never before this auditorium was decorated like this during Christmas celebration of Gurukul. So first, congratulations. Now as we enter into the Christmas season, people are wondering, and I am also rather wondering, what are we waiting for? Omicron or Advent or the Christmas? Some of us probably don't know. We are also a little bit of in confused state rather. But we, in our, with our little faith, we pray and hope the joy of Christmas will be our portion. We had an uncle, he is no more by the way. He could imagine like what our John Samuel sir preach the sermon, that kind of just imagination, and he can tell so many things. We are simply opening our mouth sometimes and looking at him what he tells. And on the Christmas Eve, he was preaching a short sermon in the congregation. You know, he came. It is a sad story for the pig, chicken, fish, hen, whatever animal that is eaten during the Christmas. I am sorry pig, I am sorry chicken, I am sorry cock, like that he was starting. And then this old man's, that imagination has become certain kind of caption during Christmas. Because in our place, I can tell you, on 24th evening or afternoon, you will hear pig crying everywhere because they are killing on that evening. And then I also wonder now, climate change is telling us, glacier is melting in the Antarctic, and then within 4 or 5 years, sea will rise to 2 to 3 meters above the sea level, and then some of the major cities will be covered by the waters. And then activists are inviting, stop eating meat. Stop celebrating grand festivals that really pollute and hit the climate. We are in confused state rather. Then we are in the paradox of life. But still then, the joy of Christmas we cannot resist. In that, I'm very glad just to wish the Gurukul community, all faculty colleagues, families, children, students, those who are physically present here, and all the children, and then their ones back at home, happy Christmas and the blessed New Year. May the joy of the Christmas and hope for the New Year be our portion. May God bless us. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your words of greetings, and it was an encouragement for each and every one of us.
We have a lot of programs lined up for this beautiful evening. Please do sit back and enjoy. People say it is fun and games that lead us to Christmas hope. Christmas hope is all about celebrations, and celebrations are always accompanied by different talents for the proclamation of the gospel. Now the tiny dots of our campus will be presenting us with an action song.
and everywhere go. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go, tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere go. Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ.
Whatever little children does, they are beautiful. That clap is not enough, right? They practice long time and they all did it well. Thank you, little children, for that splendid performance. Greetings, sending cards and messages are common during the time of Christmas. And for another greetings this evening, may I call upon Mrs. Ranjita Christy Borgari, the Secretary of Women in Church and Society and UELCI, and the Executive Council Member of Lutheran World Federation, to come forward and give the Christmas greetings. As our dear madam is coming, may I also call upon Dr. Shanti Sudha Monica to come and honor dear madam before she gives us the greetings.
Respected Executive Secretary of UELCI, Principal Gurukul Lutheran Theological College and Research Institutes, faculties and staff of Gurukul, and the students, friends, and colleagues, friends of UELCI, I bring greetings on behalf of UELCI family, Indian Lutheran women, and the LWF General Secretary, Reverend Dr. Annie Brooker, and also Reverend Dr. Philip Locke, Area Secretary, Lutheran World Federation. Christmas, in this new normal, is something special that we are receiving from Almighty, for which we are not worthy, where we are uncertain of our life, the unfamiliar challenges of pandemic. As our President of Lutheran World Federation, Reverend Dr. Archbishop Musa Philippus says, but let us trust in the promise of God, God's coming into the world to bring light and life and hope amid of all the difficulties we continue to encounter. Let us prepare ourselves to receive the unexpected joy through the birth of Jesus, laid in a manger, whom we will welcome into our heart, together with humble shepherd that will bring a new hope of life and new light to the scary dark world that we are facing today. The God's unconditional grace be upon us when we celebrate a Christmas at this new normal, with lots of pain and challenges that we are facing each and every day at this new normal time. At the end, I would like to close my greetings by reading a Bible verse from Isaiah 41:10. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, I will uphold you with my victorious right hand. I wish you all Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Madam, for the words of encouragement and the greetings.
Welcoming on the stage the UELCI staff to grace us with special song and opening our hearts to some Christmas carols.
Kalam muranga thurai
Let's give a big hand for them. I think the sound is not right. Thank you for this wonderful song that you presented this evening time.
In our college, we have students representing all the states of India. We now have a special play performed by the friends from Northeast India, which will be displayed.
Surrounded by majestic mountains, gentle hillocks, grand valleys, beautiful rivers, sustenance of flora and fauna, in all hospitality and generosity, bravery encourages, varied traditions and plurality of cultures, richness of cuisines and scrumptious dishes, cultural and historical uniqueness, we represent India. From the eastern Himalayas to the Patkai Naga Hills, along with Brahmaputra bank river systems and valley plains to the eastern corner of India. Consisting of more than 200 tribes and ethnic groups, we are the Northeasterners, the region known as Gateway to East and Southeast Asia. We are known as seven sisters and one brother, or eight siblings, sharing with each one's unity in diversity with the states Arunachal Pradesh, the Dawnleaf Mountains, Assam, the gateway to Northeast, Manipur, the jewel of India, Meghalaya, the abode of clouds, Mizoram, the land of blue mountains, Nagaland, the land of festivals, Tripura, the land of diversity, and Sikkim, the Himalayan paradise. From having one of the largest and oldest monasteries of India in Tawang, Arunachal Pradesh, the Kaziranga National Park, and Kamakhya Temple of Assam, one of the world's largest river island majuli in Assam, to the home of emerald falcons in Nagaland, the abode of cherry blossoms, or the Matrilineal Society of Meghalaya, the famous Marikom of Manipur, the Cherao or bamboo dance of Mizoram, the aged old temples such as Tripura Sundari Temple of Tripura, the peace and tranquility to being the host to Kanchenjunga in Sikkim. Christmas, in a tribal context, is all about sharing and communal harmony, singing and dancing around the bonfire, sharing the joy of Christ's birth through feast, initiating the forgiveness to our fellow neighbors, and executing our love and faith through deeds and words. We, the naughty students of Gurukul, present to you the rich culture of the Northeast on the theme, If Jesus Was Born in a Tribal Context, basing on Isaiah chapter 9, Matthew chapter 1 and chapter 2, and Luke chapter 2.
Hark! The word of the righteous reign of the coming King. There will be no gloom for those who are in anguish. The yoke of your burden and the bar across your shoulders. The rod of the oppressors will be...
As you say, we shall go and register ourselves. My Lord, the time has arrived for me to deliver the baby. We need to find a place where I can rest.
Anybody there? Hello, anybody home?
Yes.
I'm Joseph, a humble carpenter. She is my wife. We came here to register ourselves and be part of my ancestral place. She is expecting to deliver anytime soon. Do you have a place for her to rest?
I'm sorry, my friend. All my relatives from city came here to spend the winter with us. And I'm afraid there is no room enough to accommodate two of you.
Collapsing, my Lord. Let's go to the next house.
Hello, can anyone hear me? Anybody? Hello?
Yes?
Can you spare a place for my wife to deliver the baby?
I'm sorry. There are not any room here, but there's a stable in my cattle farm. It is filled with hay and animals. It needs a thorough cleanup, and I would not suggest that to be a place to deliver a child. However, if you wish to, then I can clean up the barn for you and your wife.
Okay, any place will be fine. If she finds a rest, I would be grateful to your family forever.
It is not the availability of the place or a room, but the heart of innkeeper that opens the place for them. Lo and behold, the child is born. The Messiah, who is to save the world, is here. The only thing that divided the people in our context is the class division. We may not have shepherds, but we surely had the servants and workers who served under the master. Many well-to-do families kept their workers for household chores and cultivation. How I wish we will one day be free from this bondage of slavery. The chains have been holding us to serve our masters and chiefs of our village.
My friend, you do not worry, for the messenger has proclaimed many years to our ancestors about the coming of the righteous king who will set us free. When he comes, our endless efforts will be richly blessed.
Hear, O you people, hear the good news.
A messenger?
That's the voice of our messenger. Can you hear? Or is it only to my ears?
Do not be afraid, for I am bringing you good news. News of joy for you and for your people. A child is born unto us today. You will find him amongst the hay in a barn, belonging to the lowly farmer whose field you were working yesterday. Go and worship him.
Glory to God in the highest, and I bring goodwill towards every being. Glory be to the earth, and peace be dwell on whom God favor rests. Go and tell it to everyone you meet. Proclaim that the Messiah is born to us. Over the mountains and valleys, the hills and plains, proclaim what you have witnessed. I told you, the Messiah will come and we will finally be free from this oppression.
Come, let us all go and witness the birth of Messiah. Thank you.
8 முதல் 14 முடிய லூக்கா 2 அதிகாரம் வசனங்கள் 8 முதல். அப்பொழுது அந்த நாட்டிலே மேய்ப்பர்கள் வயல்வெளியில் தங்கி ராத்திரியிலே தங்கள் மந்தையை காத்து கொண்டிருந்தார்கள். அவ்வேளையில் கர்த்தருடைய தூதன் அவர்கள், கர்த்தருடைய மகிமை அவர்களை சுற்றிலும் பிரகாசித்தது, அவர்கள் மிகவும் பயந்தார்கள். தேவ தூதன் அவர்களை நோக்கி, பயப்படாதிருங்கள், இதோ எல்லா ஜனத்துக்கும் மிகுந்த சந்தோஷத்தை உண்டாக்கும் நற்செய்தியை உங்களுக்கு அறிவிக்கிறேன். இன்று கர்த்தராகிய கிறிஸ்து என்னும் இரட்சகர் உங்களுக்கு தாவீதின் ஊரிலே பிறந்திருக்கிறார். பிள்ளையை துணிகளில் சுற்றி முன்னணியில் கிடத்திருக்க காண்பீர்கள், இதுவே உங்களுக்கு அடையாளம் என்றான். அந்த க்ஷணமே பரமசேனையின் திரள் அந்த தூதனுடனே தோன்றி, உன்னதத்தில் இருக்கிற தேவனுக்கு மகிமையும் பூமியிலே சமாதானமும் மனுஷர் மேல் பிரியமும் உண்டாவதாக என்று சொல்லி தேவனை துதித்தார்கள் என்பதே.
The scripture reading is taken from Gospel according to Luke, chapter 2, verses from 8 to 14. Praise the Lord. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." Here ends the reading. Praise be to God.
Thank you for reading the word of God.
It's a great honor for us as a community to have Reverend A. Joshua Peter, the Executive Secretary of UELCA, amongst us. We are so grateful to you, sir, for accepting our invitation and your willingness to speak to us this evening. May I call upon Reverend A. Joshua Peter to come and speak to us this evening. And as he comes, to honor him, may I call upon Reverend Dr. John Samuel, sir, the former principal of our Gurukul Lutheran Theological College, to come and honor God's servant.
Respected principal of Gurukul Lutheran Theological College and Research Institute, the faculty, the staff, UELCA staff, and the entire community of the Gurukul, those of you who are sitting here and those of you who are watching me online, I'm told as I walked up, the entire system was cut down. Which I feel happy for. So I'm only visible here. then it is less stress. First of all, I would like to bring Advent greetings and advance Merry Christmas to you. The person who introduced me, he told that I happily accepted this invitation. No, I didn't. This is forced upon me. I tried to tell the principal, sorry, can you find somebody else? But he said, no, you are here in campus, we know, and we want you to bring the message. And I even had recommendation for that. But from the welcome address and greetings, I think we already have received enough messages. So I don't know what is there to add on. But however, I will try to bring some fragments of thoughts, what I would think would be fitting to this evening. When I was looking for the theme, I asked, what is the theme of Gurukul? Then they said this one. Can someone read? Exactly. I found it difficult to read it. I called Logan. What is this, Logan? In Gurukul, they gave this theme. He tried to say, resuscitate the creation. And I asked, what does it mean? I said, wait. Before you tell the meaning, first tell me how to pronounce this. Theologians are very good in coining words, finding these word, kind of words, and making jargons. And I will come back to the meaning. So I try to pronounce it. I don't know if I am pronouncing it right, but I even have transliterated in so that I'll pronounce it right. Resuscitate, right? Okay, I think I achieved. Of course, I'll get back to the meaning. I was told the meaning and I kind of found the meaning. First of all, by telling this, by choosing the theme, I'm happy we affirm that the creation is dead, kind of dead. That is very important, that we affirm certain things to be real. Then I went on to say, how did the creation die? Is it not you and me who killed the creation? So while we affirm the creation is dead, we have also killed the creation. And it is our responsibility to recreate it. Early when the world was created, of course, Adam and Eve. And last year theme was breathe, the breath of God. And by that breath, humanity came into life. The creation came into life. And of course, I'm not a scholar, neither in Old Testament, nor in the New Testament. That's the problem. When I say I don't want to preach, it's very difficult to preach in front of John Samuel Annan and everybody who are sitting here as theologians. So the entire Old Testament is all about how the creation already was dead and separated even. Of course, Martin Luther did speak of the spark of divinity still. And the Son of Man had to come to resuscitate the creation 2,000 years back. So the world should have been coming to alive or life back. But now after 2,000 years sitting here contemplating once again how to bring back this life. When we talk about Christmas, Advent, we always talk about waiting, preparing, and receiving. So Christmas is all about receiving. I think when we contemplate on this particular theme, It's more than receiving. In a way, it's not receiving, it's giving. So we talk about joy and hope associating to Christmas. What is joy? Receiving or giving? And this Christmas, I think we should contemplate on giving and be joyful. And when I wanted to understand the meaning, again, Logan tried to tell me with some examples. I said, Logan, I don't get it, really. Then he used the medical terms also, CPR and all. Then suddenly he called me and sent me a forwarded message. These days we are so used to forwarded messages. Whether you want it or not, you are part of many groups in WhatsApp. And what is unfortunate, what is really stressing is that people expect you to read them. How many words I can read in the morning? Almost every person, they start up with sending some biblical verses. Bible get bored. I can read one verse and contemplate, not so many verses. And every verse also tell me, you will be good, you will receive this, and all promising verse. But end of the day, no promise come true. And these forwarded messages, we are so used to. We receive something, even before we end the reading, we try to forward to all people we like to have them. This also says that someone else is thinking for me. So where in the beginning everyone talked about, and even principal acknowledging this beautiful decoration, being creative. And WhatsApp forwarded messages really kills us being creative. Just someone sit and write and forward, then we read and forward it. Without wanting to be creative. Then one forward message, of course, there are some good messages, and that's what Logan sent me actually. And that gave the meaning of this particular word. Most of you would have seen recently, it was about a cab driver resuscitating, trying to give life to an almost dying or dead monkey. I don't know how many of you seen the video. I can send the link. And this has been forwarded by some famous film actress and cricketers, then drawing attention of everyone, which also says, the hope is still there. And in Christmas, this is what we talk about. And the incident is about a cab driver is driving his cab. Suddenly he sees a monkey kind of couldn't climb up the tree, falling down, almost dead. And it was actually chased by a dog, which bitten severely, and then the monkey was almost dying, a small monkey. Instantly, he rushes to the monkey. Instantly, without even thinking, and grab the monkey as a child. You can see the WhatsApp as a child, and trying to run to a veterinary hospital. And before going, he could see the monkey kind of dead but still warm. Then he was kind of given training in schools, which is no longer happening again. Some first aid techniques were taught. What to do when somebody is suffocated, when somebody needs some kind of immediate life back. So this CPR training he had, and he didn't think that it is only a monkey. He started giving CPR very empathetically, emotionally, with total involvement. And in between, the cry he makes is, Sami, Sami, Sami. Literally was calling God through me, by this little effort, can you give this monkey life? And he was doing this massage very hardly. not only massage. He took the monkey and mouth to mouth, he was trying to give CPR. Just think of such incident happening in our streets. We walk by almost every day, we come across these kind of incidents on the road for human beings, and we walk off. We never ever bothered. The following week, I should make a sermon on Good Samaritan, but still I would walk off or walk by for human beings. And this is what we witnessed during the second wave. People for want of oxygen dying on streets, and we had to close our doors for our own safety, for our own security, in order that I live. I don't want to see anyone, and even those of our neighbors, in our own families even. But this man, this cab driver, I'm repeatedly telling the cab driver, because for Christmas messages, we would be looking for internet, online, everywhere, for some kind of incidents and anecdotes and stories, drawing inspiration from Europe, US and everywhere else. But in our own seat, ordinary cab driver, then mouth to mouth, he was trying to give the CPR. Finally, the almost dead monkey got revived. Then he praised God, Sami, 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 like. I understood the meaning, finally. I couldn't understand with the references, with other kind of examples. But the moment somebody tells me about the real incident, I understood. And what a joy he gets. What a joy he gets when the monkey got revived. And this joy we get only by giving, not by receiving. We always think by receiving we are blessed. But by giving, we get this joy. I also want to say one more incident and then close my thing. I always feel a little shy to quote my own family, but this time I'm going to quote my own son. An incident happened, because we always look for incidents, and when someone else does, it becomes a story, and we don't get the eyes to see what happening around and what is happening in my own home. I should be humble enough to learn from my own children. We always not satisfied the way they are growing, the way they are studying. We lose even confidence. We always say, look at the other son, look at the other boy, look at the other girl. A similar incident happened. One day, my younger son, Adam, called me. Daddy, where are you? And he calls me very rarely, I tell you. I have two boys. The older one, he always bothers me with calls. He doesn't care in which meeting I sit. He will say, you have to give me time, now I'm calling. But the second son very rarely calls me. I would be so happy if he calls me. So he called me. Where are you? He didn't ask, where are you? I have an obligation. Yes, tell me. Can you call mom and tell, I have a puppy which I want to bring it to home. My wife hates dogs. She can't allow any dog to come around. But you also have seen many dogs in my house yard. There are so many dogs. They own my house. Whether we own them or not, they own us. They are just hanging around. They keep on giving birth to many, many puppies. So every time you come to my home, at least 10 dogs and puppies will be there. So she will always be chasing them out. So he wanted permission to bring a puppy inside. I thought he has bought some very good breed somewhere. Then he said, where did you buy, my son? He said, I found the puppy in a street. Okay, tell me. I was having a tea in Girivalam, where the mountain path, and when I was about to come, this small puppy followed me. I want to bring it to the house, and you ought to give me the permission. Then I tried to tell my wife, no, this Adam is bringing a dog, don't scold him, I will come and sort it out. Then she already said, no, I cannot. I said, no, you just give permission one time. In which case, all the other dogs should be out. And only this, but in what particular place it should be there. Okay, finally sorted out. He brought during the night time. And the whole night he was awake. We didn't know what he was doing. 2 days, 3 days gone. Then the dog got integrated in the family. And when I go also, it comes and sits in near my, you know. And the name of the dog is Kannayiram. Then I was wondering, why on earth he found this dog and how can... Then I heard the story through my wife, with whom, because of her pressure, had to tell. And this is the story I want to tell you. When he was again, he spent most of his time now walking around the mountain and being in the mountain. I don't know what he's doing there. He didn't want to study, but walking, hanging around the mountain, and hundreds of sadhus are there. And then he found similarly a monkey got hit by a car, and then it was almost dying. One eye almost came out. So it was bleeding on the road. And everybody is walking and watching or walking by, and only the, and then trying to take photo, naturally, you know. Then this boy, like the cab driver, now I feel proud of my son, so I'm telling. No, very hardly we feel proud of our children. I normally don't preach taking examples from my children, but now, today I wanted to do. Then he went and grabbed the monkey, tried to give some water, this and that, he couldn't do. So he ran to a veterinary hospital and then admitted the monkey. And it was terribly hurt and bleeding. So they said, we will try, but we are not sure. So he came very late in the night. And then went very early in the morning. We didn't know about this thing. Then sadly, the monkey died in the morning. So he was completely upset. And he couldn't eat and he didn't do anything. So he just went and was sitting in the in that particular area, place, and having tea. And that is where this puppy came, when he was very sad. Then he gave his own tea and bought some biscuits and gave. But this puppy did not want to eat any of it. He didn't even touch. And that is what I would like to draw our attention in this Christmas. This small puppy did not want his tea, his biscuits. By feeding that, we could have taken photos, selfie, and this and that, because we normally are very satisfied about charity that we do. One-time charity. By that we say, in Christmas, we help this much things. But then he, when we walked, the puppy walked with him. Somehow the puppy knew, this is my man. In him, I have life. Do we try to understand? Do we try to believe this? What I mean to say here is, in this campus, wherever we walk around, there are a lot of puppies, a lot of monkeys, a lot of birds, a lot of animals, a lot of people who want our attention. People who were students here in my age, and those of you who had been in the campus some 20 years back, would have known Gurukul once was a sanctuary, bird sanctuary. So many trees we had here. So many migrated bird will be here. Anga Lydia ka thalaiyattu nikkranga. Yes. And all these trees were cut down on one day. Very sadly, I'm remembering this. Because we first need to affirm that world is dead and we have killed it. And this trees were cut down and the birds were falling down, and the people here around, some took them for meat, and then so many birds, hundreds of birds, it had to be thrown out just because one person, I don't want to name the person, he could not bear the shits of the birds in the campus. And he had the asthmatic problem, and because of these bird shits, I am sick. Therefore, he brought into the matter into some committee, and the next day, literally cut down, it came in Hindu and Indian Express, telling this bird sanctuary was cut down in Gurukul Seminary. So that was the witness once. Because we talk about all good witness, we need to kind of refer back some bad stories also. We need to affirm. And this, my son, kind of got this dog because he was able to see that it needed an asylum. And because of this, I was falling on, maybe, although the name Kannayiram is very typical and very, very like, ஒரு கிராமத்து பாஷையாக இருந்தாலும் பட் நவ் த டாக் ஹேஸ் அ ஹோம் த பப்பி ஹேஸ் அ பர்சன் ஹூ டு டேக் கேர் டு பி ஃபெட் அண்ட் ரெசிட்டேட் த கிரியேஷன் ஷுட் நாட் ஓன்லி பி அ ஜார்கன் ஷுட் நாட் ஓன்லி பி அ ரிமைன் அஸ் அ கான்செப்ட் வேர் வி ட்ரை டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் அனலைஸ் அசஸ் அண்ட் பிரிங் இன் ரைட் ஆர்டிகல்ஸ் but relate to life. So I would like to conclude. 2000 years back, the baby Jesus came and resuscitated the creation. And are we going to expect every Christmas a baby Jesus to be born? I don't think it's going to happen. It's not fair to expect Jesus to be born again. Then what shall we do? You and I ought to be born as Christ in this Christmas. We need to be born. I become Savior. My Hindu friends will call Aham Brahmasmi. I am God. Maybe I don't want to call like that, but God in me. If God in me, if I affirm that I am dead, I'm dead to all this cry around me. Just affirming, acknowledging will itself give me life. And when I have love, it is my responsibility to bring life. So this Christmas shall not be a receiving Christmas for us. Let this Christmas be a giving Christmas. Giving life to people around, creation around. And let us resuscitate the creation. Merry Christmas and God bless.
Thank you, sir, for your words of encouragement. When Jesus was born and he was in this world, look at his message, it was practical. And this evening, the message that came to us is very much a practical. Once again, let us all put our hands together and thank Reverend A. Joshua Peter for those encouraging words this evening. Thank you. So now we are going to have a virtual song. So we are, as a college or institution, are blessed with different languages. Students come from different backgrounds and languages. And the next virtual song is presented to us from the students from the South India, a mixture of Tamil, Malayalam, Telugu, and Kannada language. And let's all together enjoy these virtual songs.
Thank you. Savior is born. Christmas comes again with a message of peace and love. Wish you all a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
Rinmanyinal punarnu vedale un taragam telinju vaanidhi Rinmanyinal punarnu vedale un taragam telinju vaanidhi pulkoodile ദിവ്യതാരമായി നാഥൻ വന്നു പുൽക്കൂടിലെ പുൽമെത്തയിൽ ദിവ്യതാരമായി നാഥൻ വന്നു വിശ്വമേറി
Thank you.
സ്വർഗം ഭൂവിൽ വന്ന നവ്യനാളിത് ലോകം കാത്തിരുന്ന പുണ്യനാളിത് സ്വർഗം ഭൂവിൽ വന്ന നവ്യനാളിത് മാലാഖവൃന്ദം ചേർന്നു പാടി സന്മനസ്സുള്ളോർക്ക് ശാന്തി മന്നി മാലാഖവൃന്ദം ചേർന്നു പാടി സന്മനസ്സുള്ളോർക്ക് ശാന്തി മന്നി വിശ്വ മേരി മേരി ക്രിസ്മസ് ആൻഡ് എ ഹാപ്പി ഹാപ്പി ന്യൂ ഇയർ വിശ്വ മേരി മേരി ക്രിസ്മസ് ആൻഡ് എ ഹാപ്പി ഹാപ്പി ന്യൂ ഇയർ
Scattered in different places, your initiatives to put together this song is so awesome. Thank you. Shall we all give a hand to them? Now it's time for another Christmas carol presented to us by the team fondly called as the butterflies of our community and sometimes the voice of the angels. The stage is all yours. Shall we all give a round of applause to them again?
I think for the amount of people sitting here, the clap is so less. Right? So you can keep the paper aside and give a big hand. Right, thank you, thank you. So far we have been listening to songs and messages and also greetings. So except for small children dancing. We have another group coming up with a dance. So may I call upon Jyotika and friends to come and share their performance.
জীবন মোৰ প্ৰিয় গন,
I wish I could dance like you all, but unfortunately God didn't give me those moves. Anyways, you all look good while dancing, and you have put your heart and soul into the dance. Very gifted, and it looks so divine and an excellent performance. Shall we all give a hand together again?
That's not enough, I think. Please. Thank you. Everyone cannot dance, right? But they came and danced. It's so joyous thing, right? So thank you once again. And we have a virtual song once more coming. So the wave of Christmas magic wand over this world, and behold, everything is more beautiful. To spread this message among one and all, the friends of North India will be presenting a virtual song. So let's enjoy the virtual song presented by the friends in North India.
Khamosh raaton ki thandi hawaon se. Friends, this is a Hindi Christmas carol, and this is beautiful carol, and the meaning of the song goes like this. From the wind of silent night, the sweet voice of angel saying, our liberator is born, our savior is born. The angel came on the ground saying to the shepherd, a savior is born. You will see him on the manger. Then the shepherd also worshipped him. Look at that from the east who came by following the stars. Wise men also bowed their head, and they said, our teacher is born. Even wise men also worshipped him. From the wind of silent night, the sweet voice of angel saying, our liberator is born, our savior is born. Thank you.
Oh,
Thank you, dear friends, for this wonderful song that you presented. It's not easy, people from different places to sing and to put those and sing together. So thank you all for your hard work, and it was a pleasant music. Thank you. We will welcome the Sunday school kids.
We have now a song from the Sunday school children and youths.
When we call, you can make sure that you come fast and be prepared. Followed by this, our service staffs would be presenting a special number, so they would be prepared for that. So please. the sound is not enough. Again and again to tell, to clap is not so good. All right, let's put a big hand for our little children. All right, thank you. Next on stage is our service staff. Our campus would be paralyzed. Please come if they are not there in the campus. Right? We saw during the flood season and every season. So quite often we do not see them on stage or on the limelight. And this is the day that they are on the stage. Let's all put our hands together and welcome our service staff together as they sing a song. Thank you so much for that beautiful singing. Thank you all for taking initiative. Romba arumaiya paadninga. Thank you. We'll all clap our hands and encourage them for the song that they sang, the courage that they took to come forward and to sing. All right. So we have a friend in our campus, always walking around, dancing and listening to music. Wherever he, there would be earphone in his ear, and he will jump around, right? So Frederick and the group, they would be coming forward with a variety song, right? So I asked him, please come forward. I asked him, what are you actually playing? He said, I can't tell you now. It's a secret. If I tell you, the thrill is gone. So they are going to present something thrilling. So let's sit back and enjoy.
This is to inform you that considering the COVID-19 situation, the college will not reopen physically in June for the academic year 2020 to 2021. However, as advised by the Senate of Serampore, the courses will be taught from online. Thank you.
How we are during online classes.
So friends, that's all for today. So if you have any doubts, you can ask from me. Anybody has doubt, so that you can on your mic and ask doubt? Oh, no one is having any doubt. So everyone is happy, everyone is good studying people. Okay, let me ask some questions. Pal Kirmakaran, are you there? Oh my god, this sir is asking me a question. This situation, what can I do? Okay, let me act in this way. Pal Kirpakaran, are you there? Any network issue? Pal Kirpakaran, are you there? Hello, sir? Could you hear? Hello? Sir? Hello? Sir? I couldn't get you. Signal? Is weak. Sir? Could you get me? Hello? Hello? Sir? I couldn't get you. Hello? 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 I think Pal Kirpakaran is facing network issue. Okay.
Good morning, all. The topic for today's presentation is critically analyze the growth of religious fundamentalism in India and the issue of conversion affecting the Indian church. Introduction. Religious fundamentalism is the reaction against the modern form of society, beliefs, norms, etc. It is seen as modern 20th century movement. In the modern era, the religion is ignored and the priority is given to the standards of wealth and status. They seek to form traditionally oriented, less modernized society.
Okay, friends. Okay, Daisy, thank you for the good presentation. Friends, now this is the time for you to evaluate, to give critical comments, to appreciate. This is the time. Please use it.
Hello, Daisy. What is the mixie you are using in your home? Very noisy. I think she is using Bajaj mixie. Very noisy.
It's my life. It's now or never. I ain't gonna live forever. I just want to live, I live alive.
Expectations of morning devotion. Reality of morning devotion.
It
Friends, I'm going to take attendance. So after telling your attendance, you can move.
Sir is taking attendance. Please come and say your attendance and move, please.
Camera off, mic off, sleep, repeat. Again he's going to come, Talibare.
Who is coming?
Very much aware about the reality. Everyone are waiting that Omicron will come. They don't have to come in January. All right, thank you, Frederick and team, for your presentation. And it was a joyous moment. All right.
It is time for celebration. The way to celebrate Christmas is by giving gifts. Christmas means giving. God gave God's Son, and the Son gave life. Now, without giving, there is no true Christmas. So now we call upon Ma'am Rebecca Isaiah to come on stage. As Ma'am comes, we want to invite a special guest all the way from Germany to come with this gift for our dear children.
And first of all, I would like to invite Mrs. Ranjitha Basumatari to hand over the gift. And I would like to call upon the children's names to come and collect their gift one after the other. First, baby of Mrs. Lydia, UELCI. Son of Mrs. Lydia, UELCI.
We are still waiting for the Santa Claus arrival. May I request all the children to be brought before the stage so that when the name is called, you can come.
Next. Mr. Adis V. Vinod, son of Reverend Dr. Vinod Silas. Baby Rachel, daughter of Mr. Isaac, UELCI. Baby Lung Yile Niu Mei, daughter of Haipen Tung Niu Mei. Daughter of Haipen Tung Niu Mei. Baby Lung Yile. Next, Kurapati Benai, son of Mr. Kurapati Kirti Samuel.
Children are not coming forward because Santa Claus is not coming. Yeah, please bring your children as the names are called, please. We have very limited time now.
Baby Kavinaya, daughter of Mr. Danesh. Baby Kavinaya, daughter of Danesh. Next, baby Johanna Adrel, daughter of Reverend Zivaras, UELCI. Baby Johanna Adrel. I also call upon Reverend Samuel Sundaras Singh to come and hand over the next group of eight gifts. And the first one is Mr. Vihan, son of Reverend Dr. Giri Krishnan. Mr. Vihan, son of Reverend Dr. Giri Krishnan. Next, Miss Judith Vijayan, daughter of Dr. Aravind J. Mr. Nanghul, son of Mr. Danesh. Mr. Nanghul, son of Mr. Danesh. Daughter of Haipentung Niume, Blessing Niume. Blessing Niume, daughter of Haipentung Niume.
Better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you.
Mr. Ankit V. Vinod, son of Reverend Dr. Vinod Silas.
Oh, he's making a list, and he's checking it twice.
Miss Jaisni, Miss Danira Jaisni, daughter of Reverend Dr. David Joseph. Mr. Evin Joseph, son of Mr. Rajendran. Mr. Iswaryan Rajeshekhar, son of Mrs. Vanita.
Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming.
Mr. Evan Joseph, son of Mr. Rajendran. Miss Danira Jaisni, daughter of Reverend Dr. David Joseph. Miss Jeremiah Andrill. Miss Jeremiah Andrill, daughter of Ben Jivaras, UELCI. Mr. Nahul, son of Mr. Danes. Mr. Nahul, Miss Anilan, daughter of Reverend Dr. Vijayan. And for the next, I would like to call Reverend Largi Vedha to hand over the gift. And first, Mr. Paul Joshua Nyak, son of Reverend Dr. Babu C. Nyak. Second, Miss Vaisnavi, daughter of Mrs. Ramani. Mr. Win Boas, son of Reverend Dr. Marvin Sino Boas. Mr. Benny, son of Reverend Dr. Wilson Paluri. Mr. Alfred Lemmy, son of Dr. Aravind Jayakumar. Mr. Dunning Joseph, son of Reverend Dr. David Joseph. Mr. Alif V. Vinod, son of Reverend Dr. Vinod Silas. Mr. Hari, son of UELCI staff, Mr. Babu. Mr. Hari, son of UELCI staff, Mr. Babu. Mr. Hari, son of UELCI staff, Mr. Babu. Son of Mr. Babu. Now, may we invite Reverend Joshua Peter to hand over the gift. Reverend Joshua Peter to hand over the gift. May we invite Ma'am Prasanna to hand over the gift. Ma'am Prasanna. Mr. Amis. Mr. Amis, son of Reverend Dr. Giri Krishnan. Miss Eldrina Basumatari, daughter of Reverend Dr. Songram Basumatari. Miss Angela, daughter of Reverend Dr. Wilson Paluri. Miss Angelina, daughter of Reverend Dr. Vijayan. Miss Shakti, daughter of Mr. Ravi. Miss Angelina, daughter of Reverend Dr. Vijayan. Miss Shakti, daughter of Mr. Ravi. Mr. Elroch Basumatari, son of Reverend Dr. Songram Basumatari. Mr. Elrod Basumatari, son of Reverend Dr. Songram Basumatari. Mr. Tarun, son of Mr. Ravi. Mr. Tarun, son of Mr. Ravi. Mr. Beno, son of Reverend Lardi Veda. Mr. Jio, son of Mrs. Amala, UELCI staff. Miss Beulah Evangelina, daughter of Reverend Dr. Babu Sinyak. Miss Christabel Caroline, daughter of Mrs. Rebecca Azaria. Miss Hailey, daughter of Dr. Samuel Sundaras Singh. Miss Agustina, daughter of Mrs. Gersom. Miss Ahefia Barukier, daughter of Reverend Ngangyat Swami Samuel. Miss Saini Logan, daughter of Reverend Samuel Logan. Miss Jasmine, daughter of Mrs. Ramani.
Invite our principal to come on the stage for the special prizes.
Yeah. No, just the small gift for the faculty members, administrative staff, and then service staff. So in order to save the time, I will be calling batch by batch. First faculty, administrative staff, and the service staff. with the initiative of our treasurer, Reverend Joshua Peter, Executive Secretary of UELCI. So we have just arranged a small gift so that we want to offer to our faculty and other staffs. So I invite all faculty members to come and just stand online, and then these two small toddlers will give us the gift. Yeah. Please come up on the stage, please. All the faculty members, please come. Yeah. Me. Judith, give to Uncle John Samuel. Bless you. Give to Uncle Arvin. You know Uncle Arvin? You call them, okay? Now, Judith. Okay, Reverend Nagaya is not there. The Uncle Edwin. Find out. Sorry. Let's see. Auntie Santi. Okay, Santi Monica, you know. Auntie. Yeah. I was kidding. Auntie Prasanna, you know, go there. You did? Yeah, go. Uncle Boaz, you know. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, Jacob Sundar Singh is not here, so that's it, yes. Okay, who is going to bless you? Uncle Babu, you know, yes. Yes. Uncle David Joseph. Yes. Oh, Dr. Giri here. Okay. Yeah. Who is this? Uncle Wilson. Here. Uncle Lalji. Yes. Auntie Rebecca. Uncle Peter Singh, you know, right? Ah, where is he? Uncle Peter Singh, find out. Yes, the Uncle Samuel Chondras. Yeah. Yeah, Uncle John Pradeep, you find out, where is he? Uncle Binod. Find out. Stand back. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Oh, photo. Okay. You can please go this way. Meantime, I request administrative staff to come this way, please. All the administrative staff who are working in the offices. Please. Sorry, Dr. Bijan, sorry. Come, please. Dr. Bijan. Yes. Your envelope was somewhere. Sorry. Please. Yeah. So, thank you. This is a small. Yeah. Yeah, please come. Some people don't know, so I will tell the names, okay? Here is Christopher Singh, I have given. Here is our accountant, Danes. Stephen is busy, yeah. Here is Lydia Akka. Thank you, please, okay. Here is our librarian. Here is our archivist, Rajendran. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, another library staff, Anita. Yeah, thank you. Here is principal secretary, Samila. Yeah, thank you. Here is our Maria Ka. Here is our another library staff, Sister Asa. Yeah. Yes, where is Damodaran? Here? Yes, thank you. And here is Stephen, he is here now, yes. Here is Jillu, we call him Jillu, but Tankachan, okay. Yeah, thank you. And then here is Lily, Jaya Kumar. Thank you so much. Oh, photo. Okay. Yeah. Huh? In the middle. Okay then. Yeah. Okay. Quickly a photo. Okay. Please go this way. Or yeah. Thank you. Yeah, okay. Now I call all service staff, please. Yeah. All the service staff, please come. Here is our soldiers, okay? Yeah. No. Little front. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, Pushpa, huh? Yeah, this is for you, yeah. Yeah, here is Ramani Bhai. Oh, sorry. I'm confused. Ramani Bhai is there. Yeah, another Ramani. Yeah. please. Okay, Ramanika, this is for you. Yeah, Kalakahia. Yes. Yeah. Okay, Moanana.
Yeah.
Adakshani. Oh, Adakshani. Adakshani here. Yeah. Thank you. Ajita. Come on, Ajita. Yeah, yes, this way. Chinnatambi. Yeah. Now another Ramani. Yes, now here. Vikala. Now it is yours. Come on, please. Oh, yeah. Yes, yes, our electrician, Rabbi. Here, yes, yes. Here is Krishna. Yeah, Radhika. Yeah. Adasana. Yeah. Photo. Yeah. Thank you. Over to MCs.
Thank you, sir, for... Yeah, we are coming to the end of the Christmas service of 2021. And before we go into vote of thanks, we will be viewing that drama done by our Northeast friends here in the campus. So, that was interrupted because of some technical failure. So, may I ask... Get ready.
Surrounded by majestic mountains, gentle hillocks, grand valleys, with sustenance of flora and fauna, in all hospitality and generosity, bravery encourages, varied traditions and plurality of cultures. Richness of cuisines and scrumptious dishes. Cultural and historical uniqueness, we represent India. From the eastern Himalayas to the Patkai Naga Hills, along with Brahmaputra Bank River systems and valley plains to the eastern corner of India. Consisting of more than 200 tribes and ethnic groups, we are the Northeasterners, the region known as Gateway to East and Southeast Asia. We are known as seven sisters and one brother, or eight siblings, sharing with each one's unity in diversity with the states, Arunachal Pradesh, the Dawnleaf Mountains, Assam, the gateway to Northeast, Manipur, the jewel of India, Meghalaya, the abode of clouds, Mizoram, the land of blue mountains, Nagaland, the land of festivals, Tripura, the land of diversity, and Sikkim, the Himalayan paradise. From having one of the largest and oldest monasteries of India in Tawang, Arunachal Pradesh, the Kaziranga National Park and Kamakhya Temple of Assam, one of the world's largest river island Majuli in Assam, to the home of emerald falcons in Nagaland, the abode of cherry blossoms, or the Matrilineal Society of Meghalaya, the famous Marikom of Manipur, the Cherao or Bamboo Dance of Mizoram, the aged old temples such as Tripura Sundari Temple of Tripura, the peace and tranquility to being the host to Kanchenjunga in Sikkim. Christmas, in a tribal context, is all about sharing and communal harmony, singing and dancing around the bonfire, sharing the joy of Christ's birth through feast, initiating the forgiveness to our fellow neighbors, and executing our love and faith through deeds and words. We, the Northeast students of Gurukul, present to you the rich culture of the Northeast on the theme, If Jesus Was Born in a Tribal Context, basing on Isaiah chapter 9, Matthew chapter 1 and chapter 2, and Luke chapter 2.
Hark! The word of the righteous reign of the coming king. There will be no gloom for those who are in anguish. The yoke of your burden and the bar across your shoulders. The rod of the oppressors will be all vanished when the Messiah comes. For a child is born for us, a son is given to us. All authority rests upon his shoulder, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Parent, God of Peace.
Family, clan, ancestral village, and kingship connects the tribals. It is not about one member of a family. It's not about two members, but it's about family lineage and keeping the roots alive.
Mary, let us go to our ancestral village and get familiar with them. Register as one of them. The baby in your womb needs to know the identity and genealogy of our Davidic lineage.
As you say, we shall go and register ourselves. My Lord, the time has arrived for me to deliver the baby. We need to find a place where I can rest.
Anybody there? Hello, anybody home?
Yes.
I'm Joseph, a humble carpenter. She is my wife. We came here to register ourselves and be part of my ancestral place. She is expecting to deliver anytime soon. Do you have a place for her to rest?
I'm sorry, my friend. All my relatives from city came here to spend the winter with us. And I'm afraid there is no room enough to accommodate two of you.
Hello! Hello!
I am collapsing, my lord. Let's go to the next house.
Hello! Can anyone hear me? Anybody? Hello!
Yes?
Can you spare a place for my wife to deliver the baby?
I'm sorry. There are not any room here, but there's a stable in my cattle farm. It is filled with hay and animals. It needs a thorough cleanup, and I would not suggest that to be a place to deliver a child. However, if you wish to, then I can clean up the barn for you and your wife.
Okay, any place will be fine if she finds a rest. I would be grateful to your family forever.
It is not the availability of the place or a room, but the heart of innkeeper that opens the place for them. Lo and behold, the child is born. The Messiah who is to save the world is here. The only thing that divided the people in our context is the class division. We may not have shepherds, but we surely had the servants and workers who served under the master. Many well-to-do families kept their workers for household chores and cultivation.
How I wish we will one day be free from this bondage of slavery. The chains have been holding us to serve our masters and chiefs of our village.
My friend, you do not worry, for the messenger has proclaimed many years to our ancestors about the coming of the righteous king who will set us free. When he comes, our endless efforts will be richly blessed.
Hear, O you people, hear the good news.
A messenger?
That's the voice of our messenger. Can you hear? Or is it only to my ears?
Do not be afraid, for I am bringing you good news, news of joy for you and for your people. A child is born unto us today. You will find him amongst the hay in a barn belonging to the lowly farmer whose field you were working yesterday. Go and worship him.
Glory to God in the highest, and I bring goodwill towards every being. Glory be to the earth, and peace be dwell on whom God's favor rests.
Go and tell it to everyone you meet. Proclaim that the Messiah is born to us. Over the mountains and valleys, the hills and plains, proclaim what you have witnessed.
Ah, I told you, the Messiah will come and we will finally be free from this oppression.
Come, let us all go and witness the birth of Messiah and pay him our adoration.
Chieftains played an important role in decision making. They are also learned and experienced in every sphere of life. Each village has chieftains who maintain the order in the society. So, the star gave them a hope of a new world, and they decided to follow the star.
My king, we have come from a far away land to witness the newly born king.
My lord, where's the one who has been born to be our king?
We have witnessed a star rising up from afar. My king, a star shined brightly above has been leading us all our way. The nature always gives us sign about birth and death, cultivation and harvest. Today, we have seen a star that is full of wonderful. Thus, we have come to pay homage to the king who is born to us.
King, I am the king. If there is a king who is born, that would be my son born out of my blood. But if you have seen a sign, do not forget to inform me. I will worship.
The star guided them from the east till the place where the baby lay. They offered him their precious artifact representing their respective cultures and tribe. The tribals would never let anyone suffer alone. It may be the birth of a child or the dead. They would come together either for celebration or to mourn. This is a prized value of every tribals.
Here all blazers, we have gathered here to do a task for the coming king that is born to us. I, along with my friends, were blessed enough to witness the Messiah born to us.
However, when we meet the present king, he seems to have another plan. It has come to our knowledge that he has planned to kill any child below 2 years of age.
Therefore, we have invited all the representatives from 3 villages to discuss on this matter, that no matter what happens, we shall all open our heart and homes to protect the baby Jesus. He may be just a child today, but one day he will grow up to remove our earthly struggles.
I agree. It is our tribal values to stand together as one for what is truth and fight against evil. We are not one, but we are a community divided by villages and boundaries. Under the umbrella of our Creator, who we have worshipped all our life, there is no division. I, along with my village, will try our best to save the baby.
Truly, he is the Son of God. Our hearts cannot contain the joy we felt when we first met the baby. Truly, he came not to destroy but rebuild the nations. Maybe this is the time to show what we are really made of. Not violence, but peaceful protection for the baby born to us.
Glory be to God in the highest. We shall all win the fight, not by using our weapons, but by the spirit of oneness shown by our ancestors.
Over the years, many tribal values have been reformed. Yet, the oneness we share in unity in diversity remains the same. Every Christmas is a reminder of the values passed down from generation to generations. To be kind, compassionate, generous, honest, peaceful, faithful, and be courageous. Sitting around the fire, singing and dancing together, sharing a bread of our home with the fellow neighbors, offering help to anyone, opening the homes to any visitors
and standing as one, for we are divided by sects, but united by our fellows and in God who created us. Thank you.
We want to appreciate our campus Northeast friends for putting this video and communicating the birth of Jesus if it would have been in the tribal villages of India. Right, once again, let us give our hands together for these friends for their... All right, so we are coming to the end of today's program, and to give thanks to all of us and for what the Lord has done this evening, may I call upon Reverend Dr. Edwin Jevaraj, the convener of this program, to come and share the vote of thanks. Followed by that, we will be having the candle lighting. So please circulate the candle so that it would be easy for us.
Christmas reminds us of God's greatest gift given to humanity. We cannot forget those of our friends who gave their time and talents for the success of this program this evening. First of all, I would like to give thanks to Reverend A. Joshua Peter, Executive Secretary of UELCI. We are so much encouraged by his presence and words of blessing. From the bottom of our hearts, we say thank you to him. Our beloved principal, Reverend Dr. Songram Basumathari, we want to thank for his presence, words of encouragement, and above all, the guidance he gave to us from day one when this program was decided to be held today until this moment. Thank you so much, sir. Mrs. Ranjita Christie Borgwari, Secretary WICASULCI, for bringing us Christmas greetings. We also want to acknowledge the hard work done by the program committee, the convener of which is Dibali, and all the friends who tirelessly worked with her to ensure that the program went very well. We thank each one of you. And we also want to thank the MCs, Ms. Gloria T., Research Scholar, DTH, and Reverend Jabba Singh, for the wonderful way in which they led this program. Thank you so much. We are so much encouraged. And all those who participated, particularly Reverend Dr. Wilson Paluri, Chaplain, for the welcome speech, Reverend Dr. Peter Singh for the opening prayer, and the action song by our campus kids, guided by Kanimuthu and Sophia. We thank each one of you, and you are so special, and you made this day very special to all of us. And we thank all the ULCI staff for the beautiful song that you presented. It spoke to us in the form of music. It brought to us the Christmas message. And we want to thank all the students from Northeast India for the video that communicated us in a nutshell what Christmas means to us today. Thank you, friends. Gurukul faculty song is always special. And from the sound of, you know, clapping that we received, communicated to us that how much you enjoyed. I thank all the teachers for the wonderful song. Thank you. And we also thank our friends who read the scripture, Reverend Candidate Isaac Jesudas, who read the scripture in Tamil, P. Daisy Solomon Kumari, who read the scripture in English. Thank you. And the virtual song, students from the South, they combined, you know, the different languages in this song. I thank all the friends from the South for the beautiful virtual song. And the Gurukul administrative staff, their song is very, very special. We thoroughly enjoyed. God bless you and thank you. And Jodhika and friends for the dance. And the students from the North, the virtual song they presented. And all the Sunday school children and the youth for the special dance. And all the service staff for the song, how can we forget? You made this day very beautiful, and you helped us to experience the real Christmas. Frederick and friends, always special, mime, cannot forget. Until this comes next time, we will remember every second that we witnessed here. And the Santa Claus, of course, we got sweets. If those who did not get sweet, I do not know whether we will get, but there is special sweet will be provided to us. Thank you, Santa Claus. And please don't forget us to give us more sweets next time. And a special thanks to Reverend Dr. Nelavela Jnana Prasuna for going to offer us the closing prayer and benediction. The special committees that were formed, you know, to give leadership to the various functioning of this program. Rebecca ma'am, for the gift committee, along with him, Reverend Dr. Vinod Sailasachan, and all the team members, thank you. The gift giving program was done very, very beautifully. Thank you so much. Dr. Aravind, Reverend Jeevaraj, for the technical support that you have given us, the special usual effects. It was very, very wonderful. And thank you for the technical support that you have provided. And Reverend John Pradeep for the decoration, and along with Kim Praveen Jaban and the other friends who tirelessly worked day and night And it is acknowledged in the beginning itself. And thank you from the bottom of our hearts. And for the fellowship dinner after this program, Dr. Samuel Sounder Singh, Reverend Logan, and Brother Kirti, friends, and Nume and the friends, they made this program very, very special. You are going to experience it, I am sure. And God bless them for the hard work they did. And thanks to Robin and this team for the sound and the light, and also our dear PRO, manager, and Mohan Anna, and all the service staff and administrative staff for working and contributing for the successful conduct of this program from the beginning. Thank you again and again. God bless you. And I also thank all the family members, you know, who have come here. Thank you for taking your time off and being here. God bless you. If I have, you know, forgotten to mention any name, and I include each one of your name. Yes. Last but not the least, our MCs.
Yes, I already said.
Yes. Again, thank you. We will look forward to have you again in the coming days. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the kind words.
After this program, there will be a fellowship dinner, and I invite everyone, I request everyone to please partake and participate in the fellowship dinner, and pray and greet one another, and God bless us all. Wish you a happy Christmas and a blessed New Year. Amen.
We shall now have a candlelight. Our relationship with light is as old as our beginnings. We have always been drawn towards the light. The lighting of a candle signifies the path of illumination and realizing the true meaning of human life. It represents spirituality and devotion. As we light up the candle, we will be blessed with an angelic voice by Epidon. Let us now light the candle signifying the birth of Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world, who takes us from the path of darkness and lead us to the true light. I would like to ask our friends to switch off the lights.
After the song, I would call upon Reverend Dr. Neelavali.
Hello, hello.
Jnana Prasanna Madam to come and give us the prayer, final prayer and benediction.
Hello, 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 hello.
long awaited, precious promise, coming back again.
Thank you, Epitole, for such a beautiful song. And before I close this program with a prayer, on behalf of our principal and Gurukul and UELCA community, I would like to thank Dr. Edwin Chabraj for his leadership in organizing such a beautiful, wonderful program. We have enjoyed, cherished. Thank you so much, sir. Let's pray. Our dear God, our mother and our father, we thank you for this beautiful day. And thank you, Lord, for the Christmas celebrations all over the world. Thank you, Lord, for helping us to realize the meaning of the Christmas today once again. Thank you, Lord, for all the talents that you have given to all of us, O Lord. And I thank you, Lord, for the leadership of Dr. Edwin Chabraj and all and his team members. Lord, thank you for helping them to organize this program so well. And I also thank you, Lord, for the leadership of UELCI and Gurukul. Lord, bless them abundantly and be with them in all their endeavors, O Lord. And thank you, Lord, for all the staff, both in UELCA and Gurukul. Thank you, Lord, for all their contributions in one way or the other. Lord, as we have come to the end of this year, Lord, we commit all of us into your blessing hands. Although the world is again worrying about the new mutations of coronavirus and many other deadly diseases, and there is also a fear among all of us, Lord, we ask for your blessings and peace upon us. Help us, Lord, to celebrate this Christmas with a great joy. Help us, Lord, not to be fearful, as your birth stories tell us and affirm us not to be fearful. And you have proclaimed joy to the world and also to us. And we thank you, Lord. And in the same way, help all of us to proclaim this joy to whomever we meet. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for our children and our students and all our Gurukul community members, wherever they are. And we also thank you, Lord, for our partners, wherever they are. Bless them. Lord, thank you for all the gifts that we have received. Thank you, Lord, for all those people who have contributed towards those gifts. Lord, we thank you. And thank you, Lord, for the food that we are going to eat. Bless all those people who have toiled to make this day a wonderful day. We thank you, Lord. And we commit all of us into your blessing hands this evening. And Lord, as we are closing our academic year in this semester from today, well, Lord, we ask for your blessings until we meet again. And help all of us to enter into a blessed new year to proclaim your gospel in a more relevant and meaningful way. We thank you, Lord, once again for all of us. And we, as we are retiring for this day, give us good sleep, good rest, and help us, Lord, to get up with good energy to continue your ministry. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now let us receive the benediction. May the peace, joy, grace, and love of our Savior Jesus Christ, and the love of God and the protection of our God, the Mother and the Father, the power and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now, especially as we celebrate Christmas and forevermore. Amen.
Please be seated. And it's time to wind up our program for today. All of your presence and your participation made this evening a great success. Thank you all for your encouragement, for listening to us, and most importantly, for your precious time. We were supposed to close 2 hours, right? From timing was 5 to 7, but we are almost reaching 9. Thank you for your patience in waiting and watching.
Thank you for joining this Christmas celebration. Hope everyone has savored every moment of this program to the fullest. Peace on earth will come to stay when we live Christmas every day.
Thank you. We want to wish Christmas. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas. We have Santa, he's on the back side. Thank you. Go in peace.